The next poem is called Ritual Number One. I haven't written the rest yet, but it's kind of promised to myself. And just say it's my way of expressing intimacy. I have felt it all day. I have bent into mirrors, tried to squeeze that sore peak, my thumb and index nail pushing in red borders, not pressing, not breaking skin. You whisper, "Let me get it." Your thumbs press down then inward from the top, the sides, your technique to get the queen. There is the toothpaste, the bleeders, the juicy Lucy, the grain of rice. I hear you pull your lip into your teeth. You want to get this right. Get it clean. I feel a nerve ending snap and you gently gasping, "Oh." The street lamp lights our room as if it were the smallest shard of the moon. The wheels of a truck slowly flap and desist. You hold your thumbnail up with the smallest of ejaculations. I showed that poem to the poet Bill Levine, and he said, "Well, that's the most original love poem I ever read, and it shouldn't have been written." So he was very encouraging. Very encouraging. And Kazi's laughing because he knows. Anyhow, this one's called Tutorial at GW Hospital. It was Thursday afternoon again, and I was carrying your poems in a red folder through the smell of mop water and mold. I thought I would find you buckled to your chair, pushed too close to the TV, your arms folded beneath a towel taped to your shoulder like wings. But instead you were in bed, the blue sheet pulled so tightly around you, it strapped you down. I pulled it like a stiff door to your ankles and held the plastic frame of black letters to your toes. For 2 months, you had kicked N-O so fiercely, your words sounded like storms. I had not known I was such a poor speller. But that day, I read A-C-O-N-T-R-A-D-I-C-T-I-O-N, a contradiction without stumbling, and together we smiled. Without knocking, a nurse entered and ripped a sheet to a patch of gauze by your hip. I saw. The nurse poured a cup of white paste into your side. It gurgled with her fist squeezing the turkey base pump into the plastic syringe, draining like sink water under your skin. You kicked through the bars caging your bed, but I stood there, legally unable to touch you.